man with a foolish grin is keeping perfectly still. But nobody wants to know him. They can see that he's just a fool. And he never gives an answer, but the fool on the hill sees the sun going down, and the eyes in his head see the world spinning round. Well, on the way, head in a cloud, a man of a thousand voices talking perfectly loud. But nobody ever hears him or the sound he appears to make. And he never seems to notice, but the fool on the hill sees the sun going down, and the eyes in his head see the world spinning
Hill. And if you're watching this, that means maybe you're a fool on the hill. Today is June 5th, I do believe. It is my older brother's birthday, Sven. You know, happy birthday if you watch these videos. I don't think he does, but you know, it's Operation End Times. I'm your Jedi Warrior for Jesus, Bent Hellestead. You know, it's another glorious day out here in San Jose, California. You know, we are truly blessed because we just have absolutely the best weather in the world. You know, I watch all the weather reports from around the world, and whether it's Europe or the Midwest out in Oklahoma or the East Coast or, the Middle East, Africa, Asia, over in India, China, you know, Russia. Nothing but, you know, extreme weather, apocalyptic weather, end time weather. You know, all symptomatic and manifestations of what's going on. And I've said it before, but I'll say it again. You know, we're living in the most amazing times you could possibly imagine. And, you know, today's topic is kind of the fool on the hill. You know, there's a lot of fools running around. You know, those that are walking the shadow path that are in darkness, they're stumbling and they're bumbling around in the wilderness. And they're a bunch of fools, a bunch of blind fools. But, you know, don't take any offense because, you know, if it wasn't for amazing grace, you know, I was once lost, now I'm found, was blind, but now I see, you know, so I know what the blind fool is. I've been one. But, you know, if you're seeing the light, And, you know, 2013 is this incredible year of manifestation. So both the shadow side and darkness is manifesting in bad ways because the tide is turning. But if you're on the light side, you know, God is literally manifesting the glory of God right in front of you in the most amazing, incredible ways. But, you know, part of the walk on the light side, walking with God, is you have to be willing to be a fool on the hill. And, you know, even in Proverbs, it says, the wisdom of God is foolishness to the eyes of mortal men. And, you know, we're told, you know, if we're going to walk the walk, which is be in this world, but not of this world. And if your eyes are open to where you can see, if your ears can hear, where you can understand and discern things, you will start seeing the forest through the trees, and you will understand the truth to all these kinds of things. You know, building up your heavenly treasures versus your earthly treasures. But once you get on that walk with God, you know, it's not about hiding in the shadows or in your house. You know, it's about wearing freaky clothes and looking like a freak. You know, not looking like a Christian. Looking like you're walking with God. And God wants you to be shining like a star. You know, so you notice I usually have on a colorful hat or, you know, some kind of crazy design that, you know, draws people to me where they're like, look at that dude. You know, look at him. Look at that fool. That fool on the hill. But, you know, in the Beatles song, Fool on the Hill, that was Paul McCartney up there, the fool on the hill. The eyes in his head see the world spinning around. And, you know, that's where we're at. You know, whether you see what's spinning around, whether you're just seeing the shadow side or you're seeing the light side, you know, the glory. So there's both dark fools and light fools. But if you are a fool, if you're walking with Jesus, you're a fool on the hill. And, you know, in the Bible, there were several fools on the hill. You know, Noah was a fool on the hill. You know, when he was building that ark, I'm sure he had plenty of people mocking him and saying, Noah, what the hell are you doing? You're crazy, baby. You know, and even after the flood, his ark landed on a hill and Noah got out and planted a vineyard and he got drunk and passed out like a fool in the glory of God for what he had just accomplished. Moses was a fool on the hill. You know, he went up Mount Sinai for the commandments, and the whole time he was up there, the people had no idea what was going on, and they were just like, what the hell is that fool on the hill up to? You know, David, King David was a fool on the hill. You know, when he was a young boy, you know, he was a shepherd up in the fields with his flocks, and when the Israelites were fighting the Philistines with Goliath, you know, they were all scared of him, and it was the young shepherd boy, the fool on the hill, that played his musical instruments up there that came down and slew the giant, and that was fearless, you know, foolish for God. That's what fools do. You know, we don't think twice. We just go, baby, you know. Elijah, I think he was a fool on the hill. You know, like when the 150 men came to get him, they kept saying, hey, man of God, up on the hill, come down. You know, and he was just up there chillaxing, and he was like, you know, if I'm a man of God, you know, God will surely deal with you. And, you know, the fire just came, boom, and crispy fried, you know, I think it was 100 men, the last 50 and the captain wised up, and I don't think they got destroyed. And, you know, Abraham was kind of a fool on the hill. You know, he had several hills, you know, but he had to ultimately climb up the one hill where he built the altar where God was asking him to sacrifice his son, and he must have surely felt like a fool, you know, because he was like, what is God asking me to do? You know, but Abraham, you know, when he came out of Ur, you know, his friends were like, where are you going, man? You know, because Abraham had all sorts of property. You know, he was a wealthy man, a general, a military guy. But he was like, God's telling me to leave, to go to this new land, you know. And even when he divided the land with Lot, you know, he said, hey, what do you want, the lowlands or the highlands? And Lot said, I'll take the lowlands, which is where Sodom and Gomorrah was. And Abraham went to live in the highlands. He was the fool on the hill, you know, walking with God, just connected with God, the eyes in his head seeing the world spinning round. So, you know, that's, you know, the core of the message today for all my sisters and brothers out there, end time saints and Jedi warriors, is don't be afraid to be the fool on the hill, because that's part of the walk. And, you know, people are going to call you crazy. And you know what? We all need to shine like the morning stars we are. Shine like crazy diamonds. Because we're walking with God. So one last thing I want to just touch on, and then we'll wrap it up. But, you know, one of the distortions that is out there is from the shadow side. They want you to think that God has abandoned us or God has forsaken us. And, you know, just like they say, the angel that comes down that has the keys to hell was Abaddon. But that almost sounds like abandoned. You know why? Because he feels abandoned. You know, he's angry at God, you know, because he thinks God somehow screwed him over. But you know what? Abaddon, Satan, you know, mankind, you know what? We bring the destruction on ourselves from walking away from God. You know, God never abandons anybody. You know, Jesus, he said, "My God, why have you forsaken me?" But you know what? God didn't forsake Jesus, you know. He rose and conquered death. But that's kind of a part of the distortion field to get to plant seeds of doubt. Is they'll say, God has abandoned you or God has forsaken you. God isn't real. God doesn't listen. God can't see what you're doing in the shadows, you know. God isn't real. It doesn't matter, or who cares, you know? That's all part of the same distortion. Whereas, you know what? The truth is this, that God is real. Jesus Christ is real. And it does matter, you know? Everything you do, we are the sum totals of everything we experience, you know? And that's how we are judged, you know, by the sum totals of who we are. And that's why, you know, accepting Jesus is important, because he is our advocate and you know, basically stands before God. Because if we got to stand before God with who we are, man, we're in filthy rags, you know, because nobody has walked in perfection other than Jesus Christ, you know. But, you know, Jesus, that's part of the end time experience. Is that's the promise of Jesus, is that at the end times, at the changing of the times, when his kingdom will surely come to earth, that Jesus, he tells us, he says, you know, you will not be forsaken. In fact, he gives us two new names, which is sought out, that he seeks us out and he takes pleasure and delight in our walk with him, our walk in truth and love. And he also, there's another name that's in, I think it's in the book of Psalms, where he says your name will be called he delights in her, you know, the bride of Christ, you know. And that's our new relationship with God, our Lord and Savior, and with Jesus, you know, our King and best friend and husband, you know. So, that's just something I want to throw out there, is that's kind of what I feel is an end-time scenario, is all of us end-time saints might be pushed to the point where we have to cry out to our gods, because we reach a point where it's up to him to come and pick us up and to finish up whatever has, you know, come to pass. But that's all part of the glory, my friends, you know, that we walk in glory and then finally, boom, the skies part and here comes Jesus with, you know, the backup, you know, in all power and glory. So, the bottom and final thought that I want to leave y'all with is that don't be afraid to be the fool on the hill. Don't be afraid to shine like a diamond, a crazy diamond. Because that's the times we're living in, where we need to shine and we need to be a diamond in the kingdom of God. Now, I'm going to finish up with something I don't normally do, but I'm just going to say a prayer, because I'm trying to send out those positive energies for everybody. Heavenly Father, you are the source of all good. All blessings, knowledge, wisdom, and insight flow from you like a river. Your perfection and power we cannot hope to fully comprehend. But let our walk with you. Lead us to it. Being perfected in your Son and our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, who was and is the perfect manifestation of your will and of your love, your patience, your understanding, your compassion, your grace, your power, your honor, your mercy, and most importantly, your justice. Jesus is the Good Shepherd who leads us, who lights up our paths, showing us the way. Let us shine like crazy diamonds in His crown as His reign and His kingdom comes. Let our egos and our desires be snuffed out. Let us put on the Christ head and let it show us the way. Let us be conduits, living lightning rods, manifesting your will for your glory and for your kingdom. Father, let us feast with you. The bread, the water, the wine, and the meat that you give freely from your table. Let it nourish us and sustain us. Let your love and your truth be our desire. Let it be our foundation to stand on and our high tower of power and humility, sheltering us from the coming storm. Let us walk step for step with our Lord and King, Jesus Christ. Let us not get ahead of Him. Let us not fall behind, nor veer to the left, nor the right. Let us not be forsaken, but adored by you as a precious treasure, a blazing diamond, a fool on the hill. Thank you, Lord. May this prayer flow out to all those watching, and may more come to the channel and be blessed. And now I'm gonna rock you on out of here, you crazy diamonds, blazing diamonds, razor sharp, reflecting light, a rainbow, a prism of glory. It's time to shine. Remember back when it had begun, you shone like the sun,
shining on a blazing diamond. Now it's back, that look in your eyes, like two black holes in the skies, shining on a blazing diamond. Spirits caught up in the fire, purified from lust and desire. Morning star rises, a new day dawns, breaking the night with your shining light. Darkness fades far away, it flees and is gone. Come on, Jedi, saint and righteous sun and shine. Orion's scepter marks the summer solstice in June, dark side of the moon, shining on a blazing diamond. It threatens the shadows at night, exposed to our light. Shine on, you crazy diamond. A prism of precision, freed from the prison, now on a holy mission, riding the wind and the waves, a seer of visions. His kingdom has come, shining like the sun. Shine on, Lord. Shine like the sun. Let us all be crazy diamonds. Let us shine like never before. With your truth and your love. Thank you, Father. Let your kingdom come. Let thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. All glory to God. Praise his name. Praise his holy name. Testify, everyone, do the same. You crazy diamonds, you fools on the hill, shine on. God bless you all.